I understood her, clearly understood her, because I grew up in the South. And things I understood from my family dynamic and the women that I knew in my life, I drew on that. Having grown up and known women that had this huge struggle of being good and still being able to enjoy sex, and also just losing themselves completely to play a role, to try to please a society, and constantly living in fear and shame. For me, she grew up desperately wanting to please her parents. She was a good girl. And any kind of concept of sex felt dirty to her.
I take it from your response that you never masturbate.
Well, I tried once. It just seemed so stupid. I don't know. It just seemed like a dumb thing to do. And God, you know, and then I started worrying that my dead grandfather was maybe watching me, you know, and oh, it just seems so stupid, you know, especially when you don't know what to do with all the garbage.
It was all based on this idea of just wanting to be pure. Couldn't talk about sex because the idea of talking about sex was terrifying for her because it wasn't pure. So of course she couldn't have an orgasm. I mean, she was really messed up.
I felt that the center of Cynthia was about her sister. Am I pretty? Prettier than Anne? And that was the poignant and most profound center of who she was. That really struck me, that everything else she does is amplified from that feeling.
Do you like the way I look?
Yes.
Do you think I'm pretty?
Yes.
Prettier than Anne?
Different.
There is a painful part of it. When I hear those words, when I hear a little bit of that music, those chords of that music, there's pain in there.